What's going on, guys? My name is Stanczak, and in this video, I'm going to show you a cool, smooth text transition effect that you can do in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so what I'm first going to do is show you guys what the actual effect is, and then I'm going to break it piece by piece on how to actually create that effect. So if I go here into presentation mode, you'll see that the white flower comes up, sample text comes down, and a white line comes across like this. It's nice and smooth, and it's a very cool way to introduce a slide with a title and a subtitle. So this is just a very random example. I just found a picture on Unsplash with a white flower, so I just kind of went with it. Added in these random icons that I found from the Noun project, and then I added these two text boxes and then a white line. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys how to actually make that effect. What you have to do first is click on both the white flower and the sample text. Click on Add Animation, click on Fade, and then click on one more time for Align Animation. And make sure when you are clicking on Add Animations that you do it in this drop-down arrow right here, and you don't pick it from this area, because if you pick something from here, it's going to only apply one animation to that object and not multiple. And we want to make sure that we have two animations applying to both of those objects. All right, so now we have two animations applied to those, we next can then add an effect to this line object. So then what we can do is we can go here to Add Animation, and we're going to do the split effect. And then we're going to change it so that it's going vertical out. All right, so now we have all the animations we need for this effect to work. So now we just have to affect the timing of everything. So what I'm gonna do is go into here. I'm gonna change this to be with previous. Change these two to be with previous as well. And then this one to be with previous. All right, so now this is actually going to be the fade animation for the white flower. And the second one right here is the fade animation for the subtitle text. All right, so now that we have all the correct animations applied to each one of these objects, we then can manipulate the delays and timings as to when these animations are going to appear on the screen. All right, so for this title text and the subtitle text, you'll see that there's four animations total. There's two animations for each one of these objects. So to start, let's start with this fade animation right here for the white flower text. We're going to have this be a delay of just 0.25 seconds and then a duration of 0.5 seconds. And we're actually going to do the same thing for the subtitle text as well. All right, so now we have those two all figured out. Next, for the line animation, what we want to do is you'll see that both these animations are actually pointed downward. So if I were to play this, you'll see that they'll come in, but then they both go down. So we don't want that to happen. We want the sample text to go down, but we don't want the white flower text to go down as well. So what you can do is you click on this line animation that's designated for white flower. You go here to Effect Options, choose Up. Now it's going to move that text to go upward. And then this other text here, it's going to go downward. All right. So now what we have to do is we have to actually edit the start and stop points, which are right here. This is the green is start and the red is stop. So in order to do that, you can just go here. I'm going to hold down shift and drag it a little below that line. And then I'm going to click on this red dot, hold down shift. And if as long as you get close to where the text originally is placed, it's just going to lock in place. All right. So now when I play that, it'll slowly come in. All right, so now for the subtitle text, I'm gonna basically do the same thing, just the opposite direction. So I'm gonna hold down shift, do a little above the line, and then I'm gonna take this red dot, hold down shift and click, and drag it over this text. All right, so now those two animations are set to go, and we're actually gonna change the amount of time that they go for as just 1.5 seconds. So since they aren't traveling that far of a distance, we really don't need that much time for them to get to that location. And if you have it at like 3 seconds for such a short distance, it's going to take forever to get there. So that's why I'm going to shorten it down to just 1.5 seconds. All right, so now when we play it, you'll see that the white flower goes up, sample text goes down, and they slowly fade in and appear during the line. So some of you guys may be wondering why I actually didn't have these two appear animations starting in the beginning. This white flower text, I have it starting a little below this line, and I have this sample text starting a little above it, and I don't want that text to appear until it passes that white line. So that's why I have to delay both those text boxes just a little bit so they pass that line and then they can appear. Also, it makes the animation look really smooth because the text boxes will be already moving before they even appear, so as if it's just a fluid motion. All right, and then the last thing is this white line. So I'm just gonna increase it to 0.75 seconds, and I'm gonna have it start in the beginning because I want that to be the first thing that appears. So now when I play this, Line comes out, white flower comes up, sample text comes down, and it's a nice smooth transition. So let's say you're not actually happy with that type of animation. You can shift it up a little bit. You can shift this down a little bit. And now when I play it, it should definitely pass that line. All right, so now that we added in that white line animation, we can now put in presentation mode to see our final product. All right, so now that's what it looks like when you put in presentation mode. Looks really nice. It's a nice smooth transition to introduce a title and a subtitle to any slide. If you want to not go through all this effort, there is an effect called float in, and it does a similar thing. The only problem with float in is that it starts at a lower point and takes a while to fade in, and you can't control where it's actually going to appear. So that's why I like to make a custom animation like this, so it's a nice smooth, just subtle animation. So I hope you guys found this helpful, and if you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you could subscribe, I greatly appreciate the support. Lastly, let me know if you guys like this video in the comments below, and also what you might be interested in learning next. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.